For those of you unfamiliar with Carroll Shelby, he was an American racing legend.
My name's Carroll Shelby, and performance is my business.
He was a Texas chicken farmer and oil roughneck who became an American racing legend, where he won Sports Illustrated Driver of the Year in 1956 and 57, and capped off his career by winning Le Mans in 1959. Although Shelby retired from racing the following year, his passion for it never left. When he moved on to developing his own performance cars, Carroll was the visionary behind the Shelby Cobra, considered the pinnacle of American sports cars. The Ford GT40, the car that took down Ferrari four times in a row, and the Dodge Viper, the ultimate American exotic. And it turns out there was actually a secret one-of-a-kind car that Shelby hot-rodded in the 80s that played a part in creating the Dodge Viper. One of the most interesting untold stories in automotive history. This car has a truly unique sense of presence. I'm literally sitting where Carroll Shelby once sat. He was obsessed with creating the ultimate racing machine and was ready to make this the next one. You can't help but have a spiritual experience just sitting in it. I mean, there's so much history in this car that you can actually feel it. It's not like any other Pantera that exists in the world. This is the only one. But I'm not just sitting here because it's Carroll Shelby's Pantera. There's more to this story.
Wow, so who's Crockett and who's Tubbs?
Dave, what is it about cars that got you into this business?
Dave's not only my friend and employee, but he's a true artist. An artist that happens to be one of the greatest car builders in the world. But don't take my word for it. Just check out all the magazine covers his cars have been on.
When I was born, I was brought home from the hospital in a gold-on-gold 66 Hemi Charger. But I feel like that was a pretty rad place to start.
I'm assuming this is the Pantera you bought at the auction?
Yeah, 1,300 miles. This was used by Carroll Shelby as the test bed for the Dodge Viper.
You realize how wrong that sounds.
It sounds wrong, but it's actually incredibly right. But before we get into that, you gotta know Alejandro de Tomaso. De Tomaso was born in Argentina, but after being implicated in a plot to overthrow the president, he fled to Italy. There he raced cars and became an automotive executive who, much later in the 80s, developed the Maserati Biturbo to help save the Maserati brand. But he is best known for his work developing Italian sports cars that incorporated Shelby's design concepts into the body and chassis, and were also powered by Ford V8s. This led to a rivalry between the two in the 1960s. Shelby developed the Cobra, and De Tomaso counterpunched by naming his next car the Mangusta, which is Italian for mongoose, AKA the Cobra Killer.
The wounded snake fights back. The victor pulls its dead enemy whole.
This car, born from vengeance, would eventually evolve into the Pantera.
It's weird he used a Pantera because a Viper
has the engine in the front.
Well, again, this was a test bed. Lee Iacocca ended up giving Carroll Shelby a 360 cubic inch twin turbo NASCAR engine to put in this Pantera.
Shut up.
Seriously. At one point, Carroll Shelby, Iacocca, were trying to make the Viper a mid-engine supercar, like the Pantera, and use this one to try out different ideas to see what the Viper might become. In order to understand the significance of this, you need to know who Lee Iacocca was. A revolutionary auto executive for Ford who was instrumental in the creation of the Mustang, but also had his hands in the development of the Ford GT40 and the Shelby Cobra. When Iacocca left Ford and took over leadership of Chrysler in the early 80s, it was on the verge of bankruptcy.
If you can find a better car, buy it.
He restored the company to profitability with affordable compact vehicles like the K-Car and the original minivan, but also wanted to reinvigorate Chrysler's conservative image. His solution?
The Viper SRT10.
Calling his pal Shelby to create a new Cobra, a spiritual successor to Carroll Shelby's iconic vehicle. This would become the Viper.
I mean, I've never seen any pictures of this car, especially with Carroll.
Well, actually, it was a secret project. And that's what's cool about it. Nobody knows about this, and that's what I think is so cool. Here's the deal for those of you not taking notes. In 1962, with Lee Iacocca's help, Carroll Shelby builds the AC Cobra. The Cobra's racing dominance leads to another collaboration on the GT40, and ultimately Ford upsetting Ferrari at Le Mans in 1966. Fast forward to 1991, Shelby and Iacocca's final collaboration, the Dodge Viper, is released, leaving our Pantera to bridge the gap between these cars.
I mean, it's not that bad. It needs some love. At least everything's here.
There's a little more to this story. When I bought Carroll Shelby's Pantera at auction, I definitely raised some eyebrows.
Oh,
I spent a lot of money on a car with no engine. You may think I'm nuts, but this Pantera is the only one of its kind, so I think it's priceless. Well, there you go. As you can see, we're missing some stuff. There's a lot of mystery surrounding this car, starting with why Carroll Shelby would have pulled the twin-turbo Chrysler 360 engine and what happened to it. We can only speculate why Carroll Shelby would have abandoned this project.
Yeah, let's check out what's inside.
Oh, there's some goodies.
Got the door handle.
I'm not gonna lie, there's not a lot.
Well, let's get it back.
Cool. The engine compartment on a Pantera is fairly tight to begin with. What makes this install a bit challenging is that it has to go in as a fully assembled unit with the turbos and everything already on. So basically, this is a really, really tight fit.
Can we jack the front of the car up?
Helping at all?
Yes.
That's good right there. Come down a little bit if you can. There you go. Whoa. Keep on coming.
Can you bring down some more?
All right.
You're right on top of the motorboat.
Come down.
We good?
That's it.
Woo-hoo!
It is so tight.
Super tight. With the engine installed, we're ready to tie up the loose ends to get the car ready for Willow Springs. First is the exhaust. Put on the wheels.
All right, I got mine.
Good on this side.
And finally, give this car a hood.
Woo!
Bo's already booked track time, so Iacocca's engine needs to fire up, or else the story of Shelby's Pantera ends here.
Yeah, there we go. Shelby's Pantera is officially alive again. And that means we're ready to take this legend out to Willow Springs.
Sounds awesome. Beast. Guys, amazing job. Let's get this on the trailer. It's gonna be a long day.
Sounds great.